It's strange and maybe a little unsettling to think that one day, in a couple hundred years or so, all that exists now will be just another part of history. Perhaps sometime in, say, the 2300s, the key events of this generation will be taught and learned in classrooms. Something that happened yesterday or last week or tomorrow will be immortalized forever, although only as the answer to a tricky quiz question. But what's especially clear in modern times is that the potential rate of change between now and then could be immense. Head even further forward, to the year 3000 and beyond, and human society could well be unrecognizable. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what will future humans look like in 1000 years? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. 1000 years, one millennium, is at once an exceptionally long and deceptively short period of time. Understanding a generation to mean a period of about 30 years, there are just more than 30 of those in our 1000-year block, with each bringing the same familiar cycles of life, death, happiness, sadness, the gravity of important moments, and the steady rhythms of everyday routine. If we cast our minds back 1,000 years into the past, we can instantly see that so much has changed. While there are an estimated 8 billion people on Earth today, there were only between 300 and 400 million in 1000 AD. While that number has grown then, our planet has played host to the rise of cities, to the almost continuous waging of war, to the rise and fall of diseases, to the crumbling of empires, the Dark Ages, the Enlightenment, the Industrial Revolution, and the tech boom. Humanity certainly hasn't stood still, to the point that it's often said that were it possible to bring a past human forward in time to now, they might well fail to recognize Earth as their home. On the other hand, however, 1,000 years actually isn't so long after all. The modern human species is around 300,000 years old. So all that's happened in the last 10 centuries, as immense and vital as it may seem to us, is really just a short chapter in the overall story. We have cities that are older than 1,000 years, ancient structures that have been here for more than double that time, massive religions that have endured for longer too. More significantly, though, while 99% of the plant and animal species that have ever lived are now extinct, much of today's natural world is also far older than just a millennium. The crocodile, for example, were here for the dinosaurs. So the last 1,000 years for humanity is really but the blink of its old and reptilious eye. The key for today, however, is that for as much as human civilization has changed, the human beings themselves are really much the same. We've seen small tweaks made to our collective DNA, such as in some locations where there's been a noticeable rise in average height or in average life expectancy, which globally has upped by literal decades just since the mid-1900s. We've also seen a greater diversity emerge across our now global society, thanks to the advent of easy and accessible overseas travel, particularly within the last century. But ultimately, were our same hypothetical time traveler to be brought here again from 1,000 years past, it's not as though they would fail to recognize modern humans as humans. For all the changes that have occurred and for all the modern world might feel like a wholly alien place, we as animals aren't so radically different. But what's interesting is that many predictions for the future still aren't what you'd call conservative. No matter the steady pace of evolution we've shown up until this point, it's expected that humans will race through a long list of dramatic changes in the coming years, so that by 3000 AD, we actually might be significantly altered. The tech boom ignited with such excitement, particularly in the latter half of the 20th century, that today we've become accustomed to, and even despairing of, some of the relatively recent developments. So much so that something of a malaise could be said to have set in. But there's still always a carrot at the end of the stick. And for many, that carrot is post-biology. Across a wide range of aspects, it's tipped that the human body will soon become significantly enhanced by inorganic means. We've had additional devices such as eyeglasses, hearing aids, and pacemakers for decades now. But the human species in the future is in line for such upgrades as inbuilt visual translators to effectively end blindness, hypersensitivity auditory aids to enable wearers not just to hear at optimum human level, but beyond it, and wholly artificial hearts that pump blood through our veins with infallible efficiency. This quest for ultimate efficiency is really at the heart of most of the current predictions for our future. For instance, with languages, where some foresee inbuilt translator chips cut into our brains so that nothing is beyond our understanding. From signs and menus to entire novels, our eyes will decipher all written texts. But even more impressively, we should also be able to understand every single other person. Even in a conversation with multiple different languages spoken, all of the information should instantly be translated via AI in and around our ears, so that there's zero chance of confusion. These changes wouldn't necessarily show on the surface of the human body, but they would still be game-changing to our development. In fact, many of the most important changes perhaps wouldn't be immediately visible. Much has been made of the emergence of nanotechnology in recent times, and of CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing. And both could mean that our insides run differently, perhaps even long before 1,000 years from now. If the highest predictions ring true, we'll all have armies of tiny, tiny machines riding through our bloodstreams, hell-bent on custom servicing our own bodies in whatever way is needed. Preventing blood clots, dismantling tumors, eradicating viruses, filtering oxygen, meticulously sorting through the content of our digestive systems. Nothing will be left to chance or plain old organic evolution anymore. And really, while these upgrades won't directly show on our outsides, perhaps they will indirectly, as we should all look and feel fresher, probably younger, and generally more polished. The darker side to all of this is that we could well all end up looking pretty much the same once the machines inside us land on the optimum conditions for a human body. How do you think this particular part will play out? There are some predictions towards immortality, too, within just the next 100 years, let alone 1,000. And again, possibly spurred on by genetic enhancements that first serve to reverse the aging process in our body's cells, and then to stop it completely. This would theoretically lead to a human society without the physical signs of aging as well. Without irreversibly gray hair, for example, or wrinkled skin, creaky joints. Bizarrely, this could also make it impossible to tell one generation from the next, so that you and your grandmother, or even you and your great-great-great-grandmother, look very much alike. And finally, there's the impact that space travel might have on our appearance, too. If NASA, SpaceX, and the rest are to be believed, then we should have a human presence on the Moon and Mars by the end of this century. By the end of this millennium, then, we could be even more spread out. And our new interplanetary status could manifest itself in our bodies and faces. Changing gravity may stretch and compact our spines, leading to big differences in our heights and in our general builds. Differing levels of sunlight could lead to larger or smaller eyes, as our pupils work to harvest only the amount of light required. Our inevitably changing diets will show in various ways too, affecting our skin, hair, fingernails, and more. Or, if we were to instill a universal diet of optimum synthetic nutrition, then this could be another area through which we all actually end up the same. In general, as we look into our own future, we are then met with some potential contradictions. On the one hand, it's predicted that we could be extremely changed, fast-tracking through evolution much quicker than we have in the last 1,000 years of history. Powered by post-biological technology, we might have enhanced our bodies beyond all recognition. And without aging or death to worry about, we could all be forever young. However, on the other hand, for all the dramatic upheaval that we're predicted to face, it might be that the end result is something like a species of lookalikes. Consider the potential development of cloning technology in the coming centuries too, and our path towards a futuristic sameness becomes arguably clearer and clearer. What do you think will happen? Are we heading for better times or worse? Let us know in the comments, because that's what future human beings could look like in 1,000 years. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.